You know, when I consider this year's theme, Excellence in Execution, it certainly describes what the board and IEDU have done this term. We strive to do every day is excellence in execution in a variety of ways. First, assisting the applicants on their pathways to certification, setting policy, determining the standards, and upholding the code of ethics. The 21st century regulator should focus on risk management and harm reduction. I am proud to say that IEDU has chosen to move beyond a program-centric model of compliance to a problem-centric model, including a harm reduction framework. This requires us looking at and reducing any barriers to certification while we ensure that we stay competent and at the cutting edge of our disciplines. These new implemented initiatives reduce the risk to the public and to the employers and add value to our designations. For example, making members certified within specific timelines and then completing continuous professional development to maintain competence. Making members, adding the English language proficiency requirement and the professional practice exam for internationally trained professionals. Ensuring that our members are equipped with the skills and knowledge to be relevant in and current in their professions. Let me illustrate this further. We are revitalizing our admissions committee in preparation for the new IT system, which will allow for online file review. Extensive training and ongoing sessions are occurring for this mission readiness to occur when the remote file review goes online. A total of 15 new file reviewers are being trained on the following: in all aspects of certification and IEDU policies, on Canadian and international academics and equivalencies, experience review, Canadian technology accreditation criteria, national standards, competency assessment, prior learning assessment, recognition, and technology proposals and reports. Also, they'll be trained on Ontario human rights legislation, Accessibility for Ontarians with Disabilities Act, managing cultural differences. So who wants to be a file reviewer? There's a lot of training here. The reviewers also must attend sessions on the OSET professional practice exam and seminars, technology proposals and reports. They must also review in detail the conflict of interest section of the PPE exam. They are required to complete training, have an understanding, apply, and implement FAR PACTA legislation, the Fair Access Law. Training on file review is being done by senior file reviewers on staff already, other senior members, the admissions committee, the manager of admissions and certification, and other experts as required to get this training complete. As we entered this first year of CPD, much work continues in the background and behind the scenes to prepare for the first compliance cycle. The electronic portfolio to record professional development activities will be launched shortly. As a matter of fact, if you already haven't done so, please see the table that Sherry McMahon is hosting on the CPD portal that we'll be implementing shortly. Out in the hallway beside the registration desk. The IEDU staff will be happy to show that to you. The CPD committee developed guidelines and key messages, including an approval process for chapters interested in hosting and developing CPD activities to ensure that any of their initiatives will count as valid CPD. Fact sheets, at-a-glance brochure, along with articles in the OT, including one in this next issue, has already been developed. working with the professional affairs and services, the original CPD presentation that our registrar and I have been presenting to a few chapters has been worked into a high-demand webinar to reach more of the membership. The IAEDU director and staff are meeting with various CPD providers, such as OSPE and the Ontario Community Colleges, to share our CPD requirements. Members continue to call us and to email us at cpd.osat.org with their questions and to request guidance in planning their CPD activities. New certification requirements were introduced this year to further pathways to and manage our risk. IAEDU made a commitment to remove the mandatory Canadian experience while staying true to our requirement to prove facility with the working language, standards, codes, and practices of the discipline, which was normally proven by working in Canada for 1 year. The IAEDU committee responsible developed an elegant solution with the introduction of two new initiatives. The first is a level 7 equivalence to the Canadian language benchmark for all skills, listening, reading, writing, and speaking. This was implemented for all applicants with exemptions to graduate from Canadian programs and for graduates from countries which are exempt by Ontario colleges. The second is the addition of the internationally trained professionals practice ebook, the exam, and seminar that have additional content in legislation and professional practice, workplace culture, and health and safety. Since the PPE is already a certification requirement for our membership, this does not add a barrier to anybody. Just over 10 years ago, OSAT introduced certification timelines for all associate members to ensure they would continue on to certification. Members were either given 3 years to certify or 6 years to certify if further academics were required. In reconfirming the commitment to being an association of certified members, and in keeping with our program-centric model, IAEDU has chosen to make these timelines mandatory for continued membership. The first enforcement is January of 2019. Communications with affected areas is ongoing. To wrap things up, I want to leave you with IAEDU's commitment that whether enhancing the value of our designations, providing fair and innovative pathways to certification, partnering to improve our national or Ontario standards, upholding our code of ethics and rules of professional conduct through our complaints process, disciplines and hearings, misuse of title, are all being analyzed with a focus on problem-centric solutions, demonstrating our commitment to excellence and execution for all our members. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen.